your claim together is not a single verse of the Quran is missing?
Yes.
If I show you that the Quran has verses that are missing from it, will you leave Islam?
Assalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Welcome to Muslim Reactions. Inshallah, I'll be responding to this guy. He has something important to say, you know, regarding missing verses from the glorious Quran. However, I have to say this. Please, Muslims, do not jump into people's life if you have no knowledge, because you would make a fool out of yourself. Subhanallah, come and see the way these guys were mocking these Muslims, you know, for not being able to defend themselves. And please, if you would want to be a reason why people would leave Islam, please avoid people's life. If you have no knowledge, okay, this is important. So let's go into the video.
Your claim together is not a single verse of the Quran is missing?
Yes.
If I show you that the Quran has verses that are missing from it, will you leave Islam?
It's impossible.
Sahih Muslim 1691a.
Verily Allah sent Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with truth, and he sent down the book upon him, and verse of stoning was included in what was sent down to him.
We okay, really quick. What is the book?
Quran,
right? And the verse of stoning was included, right?
Okay.
Can you show me the verse of stoning in the Quran?
What, of stoning the adulteress?
Yeah.
You want me to... All right.
Show me, give me the surah and the ayah.
This is something you know in Sharia.
Okay, so,
ladies and gentlemen, we got him.
You see exactly what I said. If you have no knowledge, please don't jump into people's life, okay? You make a big fool out of yourself, okay? It is something you can defend. Why don't you read the full hadith? Okay, this is one thing that they do. They immediately cut you short, because if you read the full hadith, you would understand why these verses are not found in the Quran. Subhanallah. But these guys, subhanallah, okay, don't allow someone to cut you short, okay? Always try to read the full text. So you pausing that hadith, this guy is reciting or reading, you realize that Umar bin Khattab is scared of something. He's scared that a time would come, people would not find this in the Quran, meaning the verse had been abrogated. They won't find this in the Quran, then they would neglect the ruling. This is the reason why Umar bin Khattab is scared. But before we go deep into this hadith, let's look at what abrogation means in the Quran. So I'll be reading from Sheikh Munajjid's side, because he gave a better explanation of these. Quoting a scholar, and I will be reading from there, inshallah. So Sheikh Muhammad Abdul Azim Az-Zarqani, may Allah have mercy on him, said the abrogation that occurred in the Quran was of three different types. Abrogation of both the verses and the ruling. The verses and the ruling, meaning you won't find the verse in the Quran, and also the ruling is gone. Abrogation of the ruling but not the verses. Secondly, abrogation of the ruling but not the verses. The ruling is gone, but the verses is seen in the Quran. We can recite them. So the third is abrogation of the verses but not the ruling, meaning the verses are gone but the ruling are intact. This is exactly what we talk about, what we see regarding the stoning of the adulterer and the adulteress. Okay, so let's see what it says. This is indicated in the Sahih report from Umar bin Khattab and Ubay bin Ka'b, according to which they said, among the words that were revealed of the Quran were the words, if an old man and an old woman commit zina, stone them both. Okay, this is exactly the verses we're talking about. And again, this is a report from Umar, but we know that this verse no longer exists on the pages of the Mus'haf or of the lips of those who recite the Quran, even though the ruling remains in effect and has not been abrogated. And you see the reason why I said if only they read the whole hadith, they would have seen the reason why Umar bin Khattab is afraid, is scared, because a time would come, people would come and not see this in the Mus'haf, then they would say this is not part of the ruling of Allah, this is not Allah has commanded okay? Stoning of the adulterer and the adulteress. You do not have to stone them because it is not found in the Quran. And subhanAllah, how true is the fear of Umar? Today we have the Quraniyun, and I'm pretty sure they wouldn't work with this ruling because we find it in the hadith of the Prophet ﷺ, but not in the Quran. Like I said, it was abrogated. The verses were abrogated, meaning you can find them in the Quran. However, the ruling still remains. Okay, and we'll be looking at two more ahadith of Umar bin Khattab, since the first ahadith this guy brought is regarding Umar bin Khattab. We'll be looking at two additional hadith where it is obvious why Umar bin Khattab is scared. The first is found in Sunan at-Tirmizi, where Umar bin Khattab said, رجم رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم ورجم أبو بكر ورجمت ولولا أني أكره أن أزيد في كتاب الله لكتبته في المصحف. Subhanallah, this is really interesting. Umar bin Khattab said, Rajama Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam stoned, wa rajama Abu Bakrin, and the Khalifa after the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, which is Abu Bakrin, stoned also, he also stoned, wa rajamtu, and I also stoned, wa lawla anni akrahu an azida fi kitabillah, if not that I hate adding to the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is a testament that the companions did not add one later or whatsoever to the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because if only they did, they would have been exposed, and the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wouldn't allow them to do that, even having known that Allah has caused those that, you know, write the book with their own hands, you know, and say this is from Allah. Subhanallah, Allah has caused those kinds of people, and we see this in Surah Al-Baqarah. Let's continue. That he would have written this in the Quran, لَكَتَبْتُهُ فِي الْمَصْحَفِ, I would have written this in the Mus'haf, in the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَإِنِّي قَدْ خَشِيتُ, and this is what I'm saying, فَإِنِّي, that I indeed am scared, أَنْ تَجِيَ قَوْ أَقْوَامٌ, that a people would come, فَلَا يَجِدُونَ فِي كِتَابِ اللَّهِ, they won't find this in the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, فَيَكْفُرُونَ بِهِ, and then they disbelieve in this. Okay, and the second hadith from Musnad Ahmad, which is also sahih, وَلَوْلَا أَنْ يَكُولُ قَائِلُونَ زَادَ أُمَرْ فِي كِتَابِ اللَّهِ, that if not for the fact that people would say, Umar has added something to the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, مَا لَيْسَ مِنْهُ, what is not part of it, لَكَتَبْتُهُ فِي نَاحِيَةٍ مِنَ الْمَصْحَفِ, I would have written it at the margin of the Quran. Okay, but then if you do that, the people already know the book of Allah, and they know this had been abrogated, they would expose you, subhanallah. They would have exposed you, and you know how insincere you are and how untrustworthy you are. But then Umar said, number one, the first reason he gave is he is scared of adding to the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And secondly, if not for the fact that people would say Umar has added something to the book of Allah, I would have done that. Add this to the margins of the glorious Quran. So when the later people come, they would see it at the margins. Yes, this is part of the book of Allah, or this has been part of the book of Allah. And however, not in the main text, but then at the margins of the glorious Quran. So, but then all of this never happened. And this is the reason why Umar, in the hadith this guy brought, is scared that, you know, people would come and, you know, not find this in the book of Allah. Lastly, please, I'm warning the Muslims, if you have no knowledge or you've not done enough research, please don't go into any argument with these people. They would defeat you and they would make you look like a clown. And at the end of the day, you'll be a laughing stock. Subhanallah, you needed to see the comments. Okay, and people could revert back to Christianity or to any other religion if people like this keep coming online and, you know, subhanAllah, I don't even know what to say. But this is Aisha. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.